pounds in the bank. Large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You've got the pick a pocket or two. You've got the pick a pocket or two.
So it's George Lee's, and that is Bill Sykes. Yeah, not Sir Richard Sykes, my old boss at Imperial College London. This guy, I thought I understood until a few days ago why he resigned as Chancellor. I'm going to tell you that story, and I'm going to show you how this is a relatively young man. I believe he's only 45 years of age still. He's been on the take ever since David Cameron took over with the coalition government in 2010, maybe 2011. Yeah, and all of it links into the massive crimes of Alex Salmond and the covers for the companies in America that are much bigger than any of the frauds that are run in the UK. Yeah, that's the Salomon brothers. Sorry, Solomon brothers. Yeah, right back to the temple, and all of that comes into the laundering apparatus that his family's firm use. And they create floors and pavings and tiles and wallpaper, and that is the piezo translation joke. Yeah, and he's got baronesses in Ireland, and his dad is a knight of the realm, and he's equally greedy. Yeah, and they issue shares to themselves. Yeah, on the FTSE 100. I thought until yesterday that I realised why he had resigned, and I'm going to show you that again. This is my website, Prof. George Lee's /revelations homepage. There is Nathaniel Charles Jacob Rothschild's director interlocks with the Hermitage Development Trust, the Institute for Jewish Policy Research, the Future of Russia Foundation, the British Sky B Broadcasting Group PLC, the Prince of Wales Charitable Foundation, and many, many more, some of them still live. Yeah, all of them run by cabinet members, the heads of our press, the heads of our monarchy, yeah, and the now shamed former coalition government with the man who picked them in the middle, Rupert Murdoch. Okay, so how do I get without any hum? So there's the Hermitage Museum in Russia, which now you can see belongs entirely to us. Okay? And let me just show you what I thought the reason was that George Osborne had resigned. Because triumphantly I proclaimed that George Osborne is on those boards with Henry Kissinger. And the evidence for that is here. There's... Yeah, the whole of the usual suspects team with the monarchy flashing by. Yeah, the name Chipping Norton flashing by. Here's directors and secretaries. Future of Russia Foundation is run by three current directors. Director and secretary details are extracted from annual returns. Lord Nathaniel Charles Jacob Rothschild, Mr. Timothy William Osborne, SJB Secretaries Limited, SJP Trust Corporation Limited, Ambassador Arthur Adair Hartman, Dr. Henry Alfred Kissinger, pictured right, the world's biggest killer, yeah, at the World Economic Forum. He was the first CIA spy, and he is a Mossad operative as well. Farrar and Company Trust Corporation, and Leonid Natsin, so as a token Russian gesture. Yeah, and he does not have any bars on his part of the graph. Yeah, and there's the alleged execution of the Romanov Tsars, when the real Romanov Tsars are actually still, when this is taking place, and I've archived it, running Heart of Midlothian Football Club. And the Budge woman is getting ever so panicky now, and she's introduced a new manager already. Yeah, there's young Nathan and old Jacob. Yeah, really crusty. Knights of the Austrian Empire. Yeah, now I'm going to show you the evidence that that's Timothy, and it's not the same director details that the one that issues shares to his family from the FTSE creation. Yeah, that's the Chancellor of Austerity George Osborne. Yeah, and he did not like his given name, George. So his given name is the actual name that he uses on the new directorates I've found. None of them he uses George in. Okay, these are the four that I found this morning based on the Looking for the Future of Russia Foundation. And when you get different, you open all four of them, and that one is the one that contains the bag of massive geopolitical crimes. Yeah, that's the running by the English-speaking countries of the whole of the empire of Putin and all of the museums in those places all over the world deploy people called Miss Saville, CBE, and all of the people that are in the frauds for the shareholding companies that are Osborne's dad's companies. Yeah, they are, I've forgotten what I was going to say, they are the folk that issue the shares to themselves, yeah, and they have celebrities like the Bake Off team to cover all of their crimes, and John Noakes of Blue Peter is also in their directorates. Okay, let me show you the pictures first. Okay, let me show you the second of those directorates and what you get. Registered in Cheltenham, where the racecourse is, for Evelyn de Rothschild, who I've also been researching in this recent times. This is what you get when you try and open that one with Mr. Timothy William Osborne, that's on the Future of Russia Foundation. Yeah, it take a little bit of time to load, but there's the 14 active directorships. This is the one that contains the Future of Russia companies. Okay, closed 10 of the 49, and he's resigned from 25, so the only 14 are now active. Puxhill, Cranham, Gloucestershire, GL4 8HP. yeah, that's the Puck joke in every one of the historic Shakespearean cover-ups. Yeah, Midsummer Night's Dream, with the money stream coming from shares that you issue to yourself and your family as the Chancellor of the once great nation. Okay, so this is Timothy, the one I've discovered. Let me show you when you try and open the second one. That's the third one. When you try and open the second one, goodness knows what menace is behind that. Yeah, but they're ashamed of that. They openly declare the Future of Russia Foundation is his, is Henry Kissinger's, is the Royal Prince's, yeah, is the Rothschild's. This is, I think, the first one. Oh, and there it is. So there it is, with the massive declaration that the Future of Russia Foundation, Quadrangle nominees, Promenade Trustees Company Limited, Quadrangle nominees, trustee companies lifting the blues. There are 50 registered companies. Yet in that massive power cabal, let me just run you through them, because I just discovered this morning. And the other alias, and it could be an alias for any of the Osborne family. Okay, Snapsphere, Pelinor Limited, yet the Arthurian jokes are all through this. Blue H Group Technologies, Eastone Group Limited, Diagem Trading Limited, Zeta Petroleum Limited PLC, Scarcella Limited, Roe Limited, Red Farn Limited, WOF Directors Ponzi Shelf Number 1. And George is a legend as a hedge fund trader in America. Telewest Communications Cotswolds Limited, this is the Chipping Norton set, all of the TV and radio broadcasting empires that they have. Discovery UK Limited, Tickside Communications, Tribeca, Black Mountain International, 2000 Limited, Eurasia, your oil services UK, the future of Russia's oil in the Rosneft scams for BP. Rhinex Energy UK Limited, Eurasia Energy Corporation Limited. Do you get the Gazprom project now right across the Baltic coast? Yeah, all the demonisation of Ukraine for that, and all of it is our English-speaking leaders. Promenade Secretaries Limited, WOF Directors Number 2 Limited, page 2 of the 50, of the 5. International Shopping Network Limited, Severn Cable Television Company Limited, Hever Investments, United Artists Learning Channel Limited, Coda Nova Limited, Liberty Flex Holdings, Living TV Group, Discovery Channel UK, the history of our corrupted world, Cable Programme Partners 1 Limited, United Artists Cable Television International. Yeah, do you get it? The links to Murdoch and B Sky B and everything that is a lie every evening at 6 o'clock. Trans Global UK Limited, Westward Distribution, Tickle Films, FlexTac B Limited, GuideR Limited, Neptune Corporate Services Limited, Neptune Directors Limited, yeah, Ponzi, and the Alternative Shelf for Tax Evasion, Neptune Corporate Services Limited, International Shopping Network again limited, yeah, and Walmart's and everything that's associated with these issues tumble. Okay, so we can get rid of that one. Oh, I better leave them up in case the video maker fails. Yeah, we've seen now the Pucks Hill Register directorates of Mr. Timothy William Osborne, who interlocks to Henry Kissinger and Jacob Rothschild and Nathan Rothschild on those, and God knows what that is. Okay, do you get the picture? Everything is censored, and this is another registration, and it's relatively innocent. I think we'll just skip that, just in case anybody's got a conscience. This is a company called Queen's Court Hayward, and it's run by another one of those Timothy, I forget the name of the search term for this one. It's slightly different from the Timothy one on the Future of Russia Foundation. Let's just have a quick look. Queen's Court Haywards Heath Limited, 70 Penland Road, Haywards Heath, West Sussex, 49 years old, and relatively innocent. There are no instantly recognisable celebrities in there, but there are a few biblical jokes, like Fuller, that is the company that ran the laundries, yeah, using the piss in Naples. Okay, Moffat's, Gardner's, Dillon's, Hall's, Hampton's, page 1, and the one that we found in the search, Brian Thomas Cook, Bell Ellis, Waltingham, Billingham, Fuller, Voltsen, Logel, Froon, Dillon, Fair, Fuller again. Yeah, many of them resigned in the 1990s. I doubt that that is anything to do with the dirty and the shenanigans. Yeah, so there is, that's that one. So he's a Osborne Arnett, looks relatively innocent, but those three are the links to the massive companies that are associated with the geopolitical manipulation of Russia and all of those other TV events, yeah, that release the false news. Okay, so you've seen the big pictures now, you've seen how the Rothschilds are terrified by that, and those are not really the most powerful Rothschilds in the world. That is Evelyn de Rothschild, and that will come tomorrow in the videos I make, if they let me live that long. Right, I'm gonna go now to George's family and what it does. Okay, let's show you the pictures. Okay, his mum's in the directorates. Yeah, and there is his picture with the crown on the front of that box. Yeah, and all of his stringent measures to try and level that sovereign debt crisis that every country in the world has, because every country in the world has chancellors like him who take the money from the bank that should be funding the democracy and put it into the tax havens, Yeah, and occasionally private eye and jokers like that accuse him of minor offences like that and stealing £7 million in tax evasion. Let me show you how they release billions into their own pockets using the FTSE 100 in London right into May of 2016. Next image. I think we've got loads at the... sorry, it's going to take a little bit of time to warm up because it's been frozen like this. So they took over from Tony Blair in 2010, and the Chancellor for Brown left a statement on his desk saying that the Treasury has been systematically emptied. Good luck with your regime. And there's John Noakes of Blue Peter. Sorry, I'm not sure whether or not we're at the beginning of my images. And John Noakes is just one of the family directors, not the same man, I presume. Yeah, you don't get pictures on Facebook, on the company check registers or any of the registers. Yeah, looking kind of decrepit now. Yeah, with the Blue Peter. I forget what the... Blue Peter is a flag they fly on the ships, but I forget the significance of it. Okay, so they are in the directorates as covers for the family, and he issues shares to himself as John Noakes, the real directorial presence. Oh, it's going to take too long this way. Chancellor's case, and I think that might be us back to the beginning. Sorry, I'm stuffed up with this. So when he first went to 11 Downing Street, he could not find it. Under stress, it's his first job. He's a really young guy, he's only 45 now. He is going to become, when his dad croaks, a baronet in the Lemon part of Ireland, and in the Bally, I forget what it is, but we'll find a map of it later on if I get a move on. Okay, so John Noakes is the directorates in the family groups. Sorry, it's moving a bit faster now. That is his dad, and that is his mum, and that is him, and he's quite different looking to his dad, but take a look at this. Yeah, this is a conspiracy theory, and I should not really do this, but that image there of those two, where are they? No, it's there's not an image of it. Google image result. There it is. That's a man called Sir Simon Jenkins, who's a dead ringer for George Osborne, and that's Sir Peter Osborne, who's not a likeness at all for George Osborne. Yeah, and they are, I don't know how that could have happened, yeah, in these very, very polite and gracious family groups. Yeah, there they are. All the bastards, all the kids that are still born. Yeah, I don't know whether or not they... I think the Osbornes are balanced, and he does look as if he has a conscience, young George, and he looks much like that one. Take a look at the nose. Yeah, it looks a bit like a knob. It might be an offensive term. Okay, and there's Sir Simon Jenkins, the one who looks like him. Oh, Lord, they're not going to let me show you that he is the boss at the National Trust and every one of the massive mansions that the baronets have to give up when I expose them. Yeah, that is what happens to every one of those buildings for Rothschilds that they have not flattened by using Bomber Harris from Butlins. Okay, Google image results. So do you see it? That's his dad, and that is his lookalike, who is no relation to him, but is head of the National Trust. And that was not me that crashed that and put that sad looking picture there. Okay, so we'll work our way through the images, and I think we're going in that direction. Yeah, and there's George. Yeah, he's lost a lot of weight, yeah, since people began to expose him as a manipulator of the future of Russia. He's a Bullingdon boy and drinks heavily. Yeah. Okay, and that's George, that is Boris and all the Bullingdons with Cameron, yeah, all of the public schoolboys that have taken over the whole world. That's Dame Savile, who's a CBE and is the museum's boss at Victoria and Albert, and various collections that George, his family, are members of. That George himself is a member of, yeah, the museum collection. I forget what it is, I'll show you it later. Okay, Osborne hedge funds. When you go to the Little Sis website, he is now recognised as a hedge fund wizard profiteer. Yeah, there he is outside the Treasury, and that woman with the Savile obfuscation name for paedophilia all over the country, she is on the future of Britain's mints boards. Yeah, and the Savile spelling is completely different to Jimmy. Yeah, the paedophile that is the friend of the Royal Prince. Yeah, and the friend of Prince Philip, who's the patron of the paedophile school at Dunblane. Yeah, this is about hard cash. Yeah, and the archiving of everything that should be the country's going into the pockets of the elite people that I'm talking about here. Okay, Dame Savile. Forget what her first name is. Osborne Hedge Funds, yeah, that's the legend that he's now got. And that is him. Osborne loses number 11 Downing Street when he was first elected in 2010, or maybe early 2011, with Nick Clegg becoming the second Prime Minister behind Cameron. He could not find his way to that doorway. Okay, and that was accurately portrayed on the news. His family, yeah, his family's business in floors and wallpapers, the Piso joke since the Roman Empire was created, and all of the Roman roads leading to Gloucester, and all of the racecourses for Evelyn de Rothschild. This is the scam that George Osborne has resigned for. Yeah, he lived with the future of Russia reputation for a couple of years after I exposed it. This one is too big. Yeah, and I saw him on the telly on Friday night looking ever so sheepish. And that nose looks like Pinocchio's, and it looks like a prick. Here we go. Right then, so let's now go to my OneNote profile for him, and I'll show you what he does, and I'll show you what the family do. He's the austerity chancellor that has to explain away the fact that the whole world now, yeah, the whole world's balance sheet says that every country is in debt to someone else. Yeah, that's every country. You cannot have every country in debt to someone else unless other countries are creditors. Yeah, and all of it is a crock of shit, and all of them know it, and all of them know that I'm coming after them, and I'm likely to be found in a pool of blood sometime soon. Okay, so he was educated in George was, did not like that name, he had to change it, but I haven't got time to show you the details of that. You'll see it when I show you them issuing the shares to themselves. Educated in Wellington School and heir to the baronetcy in Ireland, he was born in Paddington. See how he's cited as major hedge fund entrepreneur, and his dad, Sir Peter, has him built into shareholding scams. The austerity department of work and pensions are screwed, yet the minimum wage is manipulated downwards. Groomed with Cameron, and all of the tax allowances are now raised to £15,000, so nobody has to pay tax at all, so the country is struggling and its debt pool is rising, as the new Chancellor proclaimed at Heriot Watt University just 10 days ago. And his speechwriter genes take you into the peacock lines, yeah, and that's the peacock jokes shared by Paul McCartney, who's alleged to have died yesterday on Facebook. Yeah, they keep popping up obituaries for all of the massive world-owning fraudsters that have taken control of the whole world using the media, using the pop system, using all of the theatrical jokes of the Shakespearean events. Everything is now in sovereign debt, and he's a believer in using the rating agencies, which are a crude predictor of what's happening to our economy, and it's run by the mobsters that crash the banks. Okay, so false economic measures, the rating agencies panic as all banks were crashed under his predecessor's thrall, that is Mervyn King. He's still active with all of the American mobsters on the Little Sis website, where George is a legend for hedge fund profiteering. Few registrations, but Tory Club C shares, so he and John Major and Michael Ancrum and 97 others are head of the Tory Club. That's not a crime, but the Tory Club is not in a debt pool. Yet the country's in a debt pool. The Abbotsford Trust is not in a debt pool. Yeah, that's why the new Lord Advocate for Scotland and the former head of Eton School now drink with the Abbotsford Trust. And the BBC, Tory Club is just as solvent, yeah, and these are the directors of it. George Osborne, for a time, with his new name, because he did not like, George is his new name, but he never uses that on anything other than the chancellery role. Okay, so the gene pool, I've had a quick look, I cannot find very much. So he's linked to the Fries, the Aspinalls, the Loxton Peacocks, and quite sinisterly, because we've mentioned the Jewish funds that are in that massive cabal with Rothschild, he is interlocked familiarly with the Seabags of the Montefiore lineage, and more highly personal now, Horn Fisher are also two, and he's married a Curzon in 2000. Okay, yeah, really, really powerful money-broking families. Okay, I still don't get the peacock joke for McCartney and the cast of the Office comedies that made that video, yet with all of the ghost-like figures coming out of the underworld and the understairs covered. Okay, but the peacock for God is the all-seeing eye. Yeah, and that is the images of the eye on the peacock's tail. Okay, that is the mum of George Osborne. Yeah, on the board of the FTSE 100 company that issues billions of pounds to itself in a single transaction. Rothschild, okay, this is old news, but it's about the Rothschild linkage and about a place called Corfu. Yeah, so the Bullingdon boys, Boris and all of the Germans, they get pissed. Yeah, and that's the Oxford Drinking Society, featuring George Osborne and young Nathan Rothschild, who is likely to be my friend in my hometown. Okay, Tory PM in waiting, David Cameron, and the current Mayor of London, Boris Johnson, were members of the infamous Oxford University Drinking Society for Toffs, and were pictured together at the Bullingdon Club, but the picture was later withdrawn from wider usage and the BBC was moved to rectify the picture in a painting. Now a picture has emerged of the evening-suited Bullingdon Club featuring the Shadow Chancellor George Osborne and the ultra-wealthy Nathaniel Rothschild Jr., two of the key characters in the political shenanigans over who said what to who on a yacht off Corfu. That's the yachts owned by the Rothschilds in Corfu, in the Aegean. Yeah, yeah, and all of the pension funds that are in the Aegis hands. Yeah, it's totally tragic. Yeah, and the new cabinet minister, which has embroiled the new cabinet minister, Peter Mandelson, Tony Blair's spin doctor, and Hannah Mary Rothschild's favourite politician, for his sense of humour as they kill 2 million Iraqis for the Rothschild Trust, run out of Auckland. And all of that has been published by me and totally ignored by Law Enforcement UK and even Law Enforcement New Zealand, where they were registered in Parnell in Auckland. Okay, yeah, so all of it, every one of the leaders are picked by Rothschild, they're picked by Murdoch. All of them meet on those yachts, and that template never changes. They're now having to cover it up, and that's what I call panic measures. Okay, that's the next tab. Okay, this is what they're doing. So they've changed their addresses, they've changed their company IDs, and eventually when they realise that I'm onto them, they have now taken all of the registrations out of the UK and taken them to corrupted France. Yeah, and every one of the places that they are registered in is a Piso family joke for the false biblical fraud for Mark Carney behind the stable door as he releases the new currency, yeah, electronic money in billions and billions and billions, like the slot do in shares. Yeah, so they've changed the name of the company from that one, Osborne and Little. I wish I could get that other little computer further out of the way. Okay, so that's the Osborne and Little on Wikipedia is the name of George's dad's company. He's Sir Peter Osborne. Okay, company number is now 057-94611, and the companies that are just Osborne and Little are now registered in France for obfuscation reasons, and you cannot find the directors there, so let me show you who the directors are. Okay, oh, it's harder for me to get at my age. I can't barely get to the button press. Okay, so they panic. In 3rd of October 2016, yeah, group of companies accounts made up to March 2016, statement of capital following an allotment of shares on 23rd of May 2016. Don't know when George resigned. Yeah, it's later that year. View PDF, and I've got the whole of it, and what they've issued is 2 million on that one, but the one I've got further down archived, it is for a release of 1.9 billion and George is a beneficiary, which is why he does not use the name George. Okay, and we could go down and down and down. There's another 1.98, another 1.98. Yeah, listed because the Chancellor is influential enough on the FTSE 100. Yeah, his dad's tiny little wallpaper company. Right then, so, and they changed their address out of EC4, where they were registered with that simple Osborne and Little name. And there is the laser form data, that number there, 5794611, and Interiors Acquisitions Limited has changed its name. Yeah, not at all reliant on Osborne and Little. Sorry, I'll just try and get rid of the risk of that hum. Okay, and show you what is at the bottom of that. Okay, new registered office, Riverside House, 26 Ossiers Road, London, UK. Postcode, oh, we can live without that, I think. But they are now all over the place in panic. Okay, and that's the company's house registrations. Yeah, and Company Check has now refused to give you information on who issues shares, since Miss Tom and the people in my divorce case were exposed, and my brother-in-law is exposed for making hundreds of thousands out of investing £100 in his own corrupted companies, yeah, and taking the money that compensates for that in part, yeah, or accentuates that massive profiteering gesture. He now takes the fees from the university students for the education he got for free. So this is tax and expenses and embroilment for the Osbornes of getting addressed for tax evasion in his 2015 budget. So what he does when he's buying and selling houses is that he stalls on the payments. Yeah, it's like the check kiting schemes. Yeah, and all of the things that we now have where you cannot take your money from your pension funds and pay for a house, he's allowed to do it, none of the citizens can. Yeah, all of his austerity measures, none of it happens to them, all of it happens to the victims that are the taxpayers. Yeah, and you know about the tax on when people die and you have to pay the tax on their properties. Yeah, all of them immune from that as the leaders and the billionaires in our world. Allies of Yvette Cooper and the Green Party on my lobbying list. Okay, let's get on. Let me show you the people of 2006. Not sure what that is. Okay. Well, I should have shown you the company members and who they were, but I missed that opportunity. Well, here it is. Okay, Osborne and Little Group Limited, and this is the people in that company, with its name changed 3 or 4 times already. 057-94611. Yeah, filing history for the company. Yeah, and its mortgage payments. Yeah, and all of the folk that they are linked to in America and the little sis are the real estate fraudsters that were the Rothschilds to beginning, that then become the Lehman Brothers, and all of it is linked to the check kiting scams that we're talking about through the family that is the Huttons of my hometown. Yeah, just tiny little individuals that interrupt people's lives as the head of the local council to cover up these international billionaires' crimes. Okay, Sir Peter is now registered at Ossier's house. Noakes, Graham John, yet not from Blue Peter. Osborne, Felicity, Alexandra, Lady, Riverside House, 26 Ossiers Road, London. She is the wife of the baronet, who is Sir Peter. He'll be further down, I think. Okay. Appointed on 1st April 2010. Can you see how it all coincides with the impending election of their son as the most influential financier in this country? Yeah, after Mervyn King has fucked off. Osborne, Peter, Sir George. Okay, and there he is. Date of birth 1943. Relatively young family. Okay, country of residence, England, baronetcy in Ireland, right next door to County Cork, where I visited, but they're further right than that. Okay, Sir Peter. Martin Robert Henderson, Bibi Rahima Ali. Now, when we get to the register of businesses, she is the money launderer. She has 250 directorates. All of the important ones that appear in the press have only one or two, except for that registration for the future of Russia. Don't know why George was so brash in his earlier days. If that is him, yeah. Worsfold Peter. Date of birth, June 1948. Okay, so let's now show you his legend in America. Okay, this is the Little Sis website, and when you get beyond page 1, you get blocked. This is an unsupported protocol to turn it into page 2 or up to page 5. There are 5 pages for George. Right then, so let's show you page 1. Okay, and there he is. Nice looking guy, yeah. Nose like a penis. And I'm not sure, his dad's nose does not look at all like a penis. Okay, PBC, George Osborne profile. Your next MP, Treasury Observer, George Osborne. Where's the bit about him being a wizard in the hedge fund sector? There's his real name in the business sector. Yeah, and when I found it, I thought the whole world's bound to change now, but he's only got 2 companies registered under it because he's cleverer than me and he's got that third ID that I'd forgotten all about until this morning. Okay, George Gideon. Yeah, that was the name he was christened by his mum. Yeah, and he dropped it in favour of Ordinary George. Yeah, Oliver Osborne. Yeah, and all the pop music that comes out and all the linkages to the Freemasons that are the Oliver Cromwell jokes, I now begin to understand it. Oliver's army is here to pay. Yeah, they do not intend to pay. They steal relentlessly. Okay, that's his legal name, and everybody in America knows that. Okay, Brevin Howard, Bonanza as hedge fund manager. That's an article on his legend as hedge fund manager, but because it's not on this page, you're not allowed to see it. Okay, Bilderberg attendees. Yeah, so he's a Bullingdon man, he's a Bilderberg man, he is the economic forums all around the world, largely in the Alps, with the people who attend them from the massive banks that are not anything to do with government, like the central bank is not anything to do with government apart from that debt pool. Yeah, they take their Sherpas with them, and the Sherpas earn at least 250 grand a year to steal our country from its citizens. Okay, Bloomberg Markets, he's one of the 50 most influential list, yeah, and that is registered under that name that you've just seen for George Osborne. He runs, and it's continuing from there, yeah, he runs the, His Majesty's Treasury until he resigned in May, and they've got him on Little Sis as if he's not resigned yet. Yeah, maybe using the government's treasury funds for the hedge fund gambling industry. Yeah, and there's his dad, that is him. There he goes to the St. Paul's School, that's St. Paul's Girls' School, and there's a St. Girls' School under St. Paul's as well, and that is the links to Prince Charles and all the tough guys and the poofdas that are in those public school groupings. And all of them link back to the Queen's answer. Cameron is the Queen's eighth cousin by King William the Fourth, who was George the Third's youngest son. Yeah, and the head of Scottish Labour, Keza Dugdale, is his very close relative. Yeah, and that is the Dugdales of Aston Villa Football Club and the directorates, and the whole world is corrupted that way. And he's got friends in the Masters of the Horse, Alan Howard, co-founder of UK hedge fund Brevin Howard. Yeah. You should see what Evelyn de Rothschild does and his missus. Right then, Osborne and Little. This is the simple little story that this is a company that makes wallpaper and floorings. Yeah, the piezo joke out of... Yeah, so founded by Sir Peter Osborne and Anthony Little. Osborne and Little is a British manufacturer and retailer of upmarket wallpaper and fabrics. It was established and now has showrooms worldwide. It was among the brands included in the Victoria and Albert Museum's British design. Do you see why Miss Saville is in the obfuscation team? Yeah, a director at the Victoria and Albert. Yeah, and an advisor to Georgie Boy on the mint output in Britain. Right then, next one is the name change. So you can look that one up for yourself on Wikipedia if you want to see that they are massive mobsters. Yeah, they've not got much at the bank because of their expertise. Yeah, and presumably because loads of it gets pumped into the hedge funds, which are supposed to protect companies from corporate crashes. Yeah, and all the rating agencies, none of that data means anything at all, but they cite it all the time. So you've already seen those directorates. Yeah, and there's Lady Felicity Alexandra Osborne. So that's all relatively minor, and her name at that time though was Osborne and Little Group Limited. Yeah, that's when you look for Osborne and Little, it takes you straight to France. Now this is the thing that I've just told you about that woman with the 200 plus directorates. Let's get that story out of the way. She's on the board. All of the rest of them have just a few directorates. George has only got two now, and that's the Tory Club, and this is the directorates for Miss Bibi Rama Rahima Ali, the ally, yeah, in the team. Carl Shalton Beaches, Surrey, SM5 4LE. Okay, and she's registered 60 Harbury Road, Carl Shalton Beaches, Surrey, and she's got 250 directorates, unlike all the rest of them, and she's very, very busy. Yeah, resigned directorships 195, closed directorships 31, total directorships 226. Yeah, can you see how potent a force investigative journalism is? None of the press will do this. Yeah, she is the money person in Carl Shalton that launders it all over the globe before it can be accounted for. Yeah, and all of those things are against George's fiscal rules, which is why he followed on from Mervyn King and did not regulate anything, because all of them are the mafia. Sorry, I'm not sure why we've got that blockage on my tabs. Name change. Let's go further down and see what we get. So that's Ally, and there's our dad, Sir Peter. Sir Peter George Osborne holds 3 appointments at 3 active companies, resigned from Zero, and held 8 appointments at 8 dissolved companies. The combined cash at bank, and he's got a total net worth of 7.6 million, and they are accused of trying to avoid tax on that amount of money somewhere else in the story. Yeah, and so let's now go down. Sir Peter George Osborne, born 1943. Interlocks for Sir Peter George is the next tab. Okay, and I'm not sure where the French registered companies are, but we've not found them yet. And here's the okay, there's Lloyd Grossman on the boards for interlocking with Peter George Osborne directors. Yeah, do you get the TV chef jokes now? Yeah, and that beautiful woman that is Nigella Lawson, she's getting younger with every month that passes. She's just like a schoolgirl in the pictures now. Okay, yeah, he's on the board. Peter Soar, Lloyd Daniel Gilman Grossman, Mark Christopher Taylor, Niall Alexander Hobhouse, the naming of the Nile and the naming of the Niles that are related to George W. Bush's lineages. Yeah, and all the Niles in the Cheers comedies, it's the same joke, it's the same biblical joke out of Naples. Osborne and Little Group Limited, yeah, so they have got that name there, but they've got other names. Yeah, where they can register, and this is the way of finding them out. But now only the current interlocks are left on company check. You do not get the history of everyone that they've been frauding with through all of the corporate history. Okay, Jack Mervyn Frank Bayer, which is Rothschild. Graham John Noakes again. Okay, the campaign for museums. Yeah, it's quite boring, isn't it? Okay, so this is a Wikipedia profile for Sir George. He has an MA from Christchurch, Oxford. He succeeded to the baronetcy, becoming the 17th Osborne Baronet in Ballantaylor and Ballylemon. Yeah, that's the Lemons that are the football managers of Celtic, yeah, who are registered in the same places with Ian Botham of cricket fame and my wife in Exeter, which is the Bible fraud, that this is Jesus's place and the place where we discovered that Thor's Oak was hiding a Christmas tree. Yeah, that is the joke, that the saint that was Boniface came from Exeter. Yeah, and that is the massive Christianity joke. Do they know it's Christmas for Odessophile? Yeah, and the tailors are then in the Hudson's Bay Company, they are the bosses. Yeah, and all of those are a provincial region of Ireland near Cork, where we landed when I took my family. Only my eldest son was alive then. Yeah, the other two had not been conceived. In 2016, it was revealed that... Okay, so they've got the baronetcy. George gets that. It was revealed that he had made $6 million in a 2004 property deal with a developer from the Virgin Islands and a tax haven. Can you see how unintrusive that is as a revelation if they are issuing $1.9 billion in shares yet in the last few weeks when he's able to stay in the Chancellery? Let me find you that tab before we run out of time. Okay, it's further down. And all of that Wikipedia profile for George is full of pathetic gestures that mean that everybody's pensions except the cabinets are screwed. Yeah, the state pension, the qualifying age has gone from 65 to 67. Yet nobody gets a life unless you are in the fascist team. And there's the Savile woman. Rosalind Savile, Dame Rosalind Savile, DBE, FSA, FBA, alma mater of the University of Leeds. Hugh Pye Pearson, my loyal student. Yeah, director of the Wallace Collection in the ownership of Scotland. Yeah, out of Yorkshire, and that is the jokes about the ownership of the Pilgrim Fathers out of York too. Yeah, an alumna of the University of Leeds, Savile was first employed at the Victoria and Albert Museum as a canteen cashier. Get rich quick, just because your name is the same as Jimmy's, the Knight of Malta. She was named Dame Commander of the Order of the British Empire in 2009, the year after they crashed the banks, using dinner ladies as cover. Royal Mint Advisory Committee. Yeah, University of Leeds totally busted for funds. Hugh Pearson confessed that to me the other day, that he has no fund for research now. Yeah, I could have given him all of my equipment that was stolen, that was worth hundreds of thousands, that was stolen from me by Durham University and all its corrupted people, including John Snow, the newsman, who has a building named after him on the Durham campus. Right then, so French Flit, there's the shareholders tab, we'll get there soon. So when you looked at, I looked the company up with its simple name for wallpaper, there were two registrations, here they are. Osborne and Little Limited, 51 Rue Camille Pelletan, Levallois Perry, non 9200 Levallois Perry 92300. Yeah, cash not available, net worth not available, assets not available, liabilities not available. One other to account for themselves and to totally obfuscate that from regulation. George Osborne, Osborne and Little, 18 Rue de Plessis, Piquet, Clamart, 92140, Clamart, 92140, France, 0757-3293, cash, Zippo. Okay, and there's the Piquet, nothing to declare. I must have tried to find who its directors are. Share profile now dissolved. Okay, so this is Osborne and Little Limited, yeah, Rue de Piquet, and it's got shareholdings at one point in its history. Shareholders equity figure not applicable, issued share capital. They don't give you that information unless there is a share release facility. Okay. Yeah, we're not allowed to know who runs that French subsidiary. Yeah, with the simple names. Right then, let me show you that George is a beneficiary. He still gets pocket money from his mum and dad. Okay, this is the good one. Yeah, this is the shareholders release. Yeah, You won't get news like this at 6 o'clock. Yeah, it's still the paedophilia that covers Hibs and Hearts management regimes. Okay? So, let me take you down gently and show you how corrupted our country is. Statement of capital. So I'm going to the top of the corporate document and I'm going to show you how much was released and I'm going to show you who gets it. George only gets 7,000, but that's a massive conflict of interest for the Chancellor that declares that everything that we have in our government's thrall is in a debt pool. Yeah, annual return, AR01, Companies House, and I posted it yesterday, so that's yesterday's date there. But the date for this electronic format is 13th of the 5th, 2016. And you've seen one of the issuance of shares that took place in that month. This is a different one, it's bigger. Okay, Osborne and Little Group Limited. Yeah, remember what we found when we looked up Osborne and Little? Yeah, nothing. That's the key. Yeah, company type, private company, limited by shares. Registered at Riverside House, company number 0579-4611, Ossiers Road, London. That's the changed address. Officers of the company. Right, here we go. Mr. Peter Sower, we've seen him on the boards. Mr. Graham John Noakes. Lady Felicity Alexandra Osborne. Former names, no aliases. To declare person Sir Peter George Osborne. Yeah, let's get to the bottom. Because yeah. Their son is not listed, but he gets the shares. Statement of capital. Class of shares ordinary. Number allotted. Yeah, so we have to scan to the right to see that. And they're quid a piece. You see that? £1 amount paid. And the net in, number allotted, 1 million. Sorry, I said it was billions. It's 1,989,000 in one transaction in one day in May of 2016, just before the sad bastard resigns. Yeah, and we've not seen George on any of those boards, but this one, he's on it, and he gets the gifts of the shares. Okay, statement of capital totals, total numbers of shares. I thought that one of these was in the billions, but that's maybe just my rabid imagination. Okay. One transaction. Yeah, don't know how regularly he gets. So ordinary shares, shareholding one, Peter Worsfold, and this is the same as the scams that happen in Donald's companies, happen in the Queen's massive shareholding companies. Every one of those royal banks all across Canada, all across the whole of the continents that she owns. Okay, ordinary shares. So that one gets £90,000. That one gets £639,000. Peter George Osborne, the dad. That one only gets £5,000. Yeah, he must be the one who takes the scams to the post box. Or maybe pays the taxes. Okay, that is Peter Worsfold gets £5,000. Oh God. Okay, so we know all of those names. And we've now got down to shareholding 8, Andrew Buchanan, Peter Sower, Nicola Buchanan. Never heard of them before the 2016 registrations. Let's go now straight to the hub of the issue, George Osborne's pocket money. George Osborne restores his Christian name, number 11. Okay, so shareholding 11 is 81,000 to Graham Noakes. Shareholding 12 is actually George, so he's number 12, and he gets only £7,000 worth of ordinary shares. held as at the date of this return to George Gideon Oliver Osborne, his given name that is declared in Wikipedia that he does not use because he likes to be simple George, and he gets $7,000 per shareholding release for his pocket money from his mum and dad. Authenticated. This form was authorised by one of the following. Yeah. And one of the following this on this occasion is... Oh, sorry, it does not tell me who that is. CIC manager, judicial factor. Yeah, the judiciary are maybe on the take too. Like I say, do you get it? It's quite stunning. And that is the Wiggins joke. Wiggins has been all over the news again. Wiggins is related to the Balfour family and is related to the Howards of Norfolk, where we have share releases in the cathedral. Yeah, Philip Wiggett. Yeah, we missed a bit there. I'd better show you the other names just to shame them all as much as you possibly can. Peter Soar, Andrew Buchanan, Nicola Buchanan, Brenda Worsfold, Felicity Osborne, yeah, Peter Osborne, yeah, I think all the new names are now in. Chancellor. And is this what he's policy making? Oh no, ancient data before the cabinet. This is me now using that newly released information that he is prepared to take pocket money from his mum's and dad's shares as George Gideon Oliver Osborne, and it finds me two new companies, but it's not nearly as exciting as the Future of Russia find, which I found 2 years ago. Okay, date of birth May 1971, he's 45 years of age, he is openly declared as a member of parliament. And these companies are chicken feed, but they are solvent and Parliament is not. Association of Conservative Clubs Limited, registered 24 Old Queen Street, London, SWH1H9HP, and is Arts and Business Limited. Interlocking him with Miss Savile is the next one, and that's in the Business in the Community, 137 Shepherdess Walk, London North 1 7RQ. Occupation for both of those is Member of Parliament. Yeah? I have not had time to look whether or not George declares the token amounts that he got as the son of that family from the share releases. Yeah? None of them now issue the conflict of interest on their income streams and where they come from. George Gideon Oliver Osborne. Yeah, and that's the Association of Tory Clubs, and here are the 100 members that include all the names that you would expect to be solvent when everything that they run as their official paid jobs is insolvent and in the debt pool. Yeah, that's what Hammond declared, that we cannot have a life, yeah, that in Scotland we're going to get taxed so that they can have revenues in their mints. Yeah, and it does not have to come from the taxpayers in England now. It's a huge division issue, and they are walking on really, really thin ice. Association of Conservative Clubs Limited, let me show you that all the Prime Ministers are on there. Yeah, and this is the most innocent thing they do. They have 4.76 million cash at the back. Yeah, versus minus 1.68 million the previous year. Employees are unreported. Yeah, so I don't know whether or not they've got a lounge bar or a public bar. Total net worth is probably slightly further to the right. Total assets 25.36 million. Net worth 13.5 million. Last year only 3.46 million. Yeah. Do you get it? Same with the Abbotsford Trust, for Nicola's Lord Advocate and for the former head of Eton School, who is Kinloch Anderson, and the Andersons are also in these directorates. The Andersons are linked to the railroads in Canada, like the Carnegie family are. Okay, and there's all the directors flying past on the left, but it's not nearly as interesting as I thought it was going to be. Let's see if I missed the page. Well, yeah, that's so there's the full list of 100. We only got the first page, like we got on little cysts there. Okay, the full 100 directors of the Tory Club are there, but you've seen that before. I've published that for years. Yeah, do you get it? They are solvent. Our country is not. Right Honourable Sir John Major. Right Honourable Michael Denzel Xavier Portillo. All of Tony Blair's thieves. All of the regime that preceded Mrs. Thatcher's thieves. All of them are on the take. Yeah, all of the drinking clubs, all of the residences are paid for. Yeah, all of it. They're able to get their mortgages for free because they're all linked to the big banks. Yeah, and you should see Evelyn the Rothschild. Right Honourable Timothy John Crumlin Egger, Michael William Parsons. Oh, Egger, where my wife used to work. Yeah, and the cover stories for the Eggers and the killing of Dim Wim. Yeah, it's just a massive set of interlocking obfuscation tools, and all of them are on the take. Yeah, and everything that is the country's is decrepit and in a massive and rising debt pool. Not sure what that is. Oh, it's my phone. Anyway, I'd better keep going. And I think that's the joke, that they're talking about my impending debt pool. Sorry, let me just leave that there. I'll continue in a few minutes. So, that's the bosses at the Tory Club. That is now the bosses at the Arts Club that Miss Saville is in. And I think that is the end of story. Just to sex it up. Oh no, let's stop there. Yeah, so there is the Evelyn de Rothschild. And if you're listening in tomorrow, you will be absolutely stunned. Yeah, everything that is released here, including Baroness Blackstone and all the crimes of Greenwich University, all of the releasing of the economic publications of the woman that is Dame Helen Alexander, all of it is a cover for American institutions run by that massively powerful advisor to Her Majesty the Queen. Okay, I'm going to stop there now, and I think you know why George Osborne was forced into resignation. I thought it was the future of Russia fund, but his pocket money from his mum and dad is quite embarrassing, really. Okay, bye-bye.